The moral of today's story is, when you marry into a family of wasps, you better be prepared to get stung. Let's get started.
Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba-ba.
Hello, my friends. Welcome to Thumb Together. My name is Andrew Fantasia, and today we're going to be talking about Ready or Not Together. As usual, if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to give it a thumbs up and give some love to that subscribe button as well, or I will be hunted down, skinned alive, and displayed over some rich guy's mantelpiece as a conversation piece. First things first, I want to give props to this badass poster that we're all looking at right here. People in Hollywood who work at making posters, please take note. This is what a cool friggin' movie poster should look like. That's just awesome. Now, Ready or Not is one of those films that when you go into it, you really have no idea what you're in for. Even if you know what the movie's about, you don't know what you're in for in terms of quality because it's a crapshoot. As the credits start rolling, you see that more than half of the actors are Canadian actors you have never heard of before. The writers are writers you have never heard of before. And the two directors are directors you probably never heard of before either. So it's just this mishmash of names coming at you where besides like one or two character actors you might recognize, everybody else is a complete mystery and you're thinking, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into? At least that's what I was thinking as I was sitting in that theater and the lights went down. I'm like, oh boy, I don't recognize a whole lot of people here. This could go either way. But I'm happy to report that the direction Ready or Not tips into is the direction of, wow, that was pretty damn good. And it's always nice to be pleasantly surprised by a film. By anything. It's always nice to be pleasantly surprised. Who doesn't want that? If this film's completely off your radar and you have no idea what I'm talking about, it's about this lady right here, Grace. Grace is a normal lady. She's just like you and me. She's just a normal person. And she marries into this family who are worth hundreds of millions of dollars because for the past six or seven generations, they have been the cornerstone of a board game empire. Picture like the Parker brothers, okay? Like this is a family who made a fortune off selling board games and card games, and now because of that, they live in this ginormous mansion in a community full of ginormous mansions. They're known as the Ladomas family. However, just like many, many of the 1% in the real world, the Ladomas family have a few screws loose. They believe in a very disturbing family tradition. According to them, every time somebody new marries into the family, they have to play a game on the wedding night. So at midnight, they all gather around a table, they draw a card out of a randomly shuffled deck of cards, and they play whatever the game is. Most of the time, it's something fairly harmless, like checkers or old maid or something. But if you draw the card that says hide and seek, then shit gets real, because the Ladomas family are under the impression that their great-great-grandfather made a deal with the devil to get them the fortune that they have today, and the stipulation of the deal was, if any person draws the hide-and-seek card, you not only have to seek that person, you have to sacrifice them on a ritual altar in the name of Satan. So, Grace obviously has no idea what she's in for. She thinks she's playing a harmless game of hide-and-seek. She thinks it's odd and kooky, just like the rest of the family, but she goes along with it because she loves her new husband, Alex, so much. Meanwhile, Alex is terrified because this was his worst fear come true, and now he has to watch as the rest of his family hunts down his new bride. And as the movie spirals deeper and deeper into the bowels of insanity, it becomes a giant bloody mess. It is full of bodies and hacked limbs and shotgun shells and crossbow bolts and all kinds of crazy stuff flying at you. But what I really dug about Ready or Not, what really made me enjoy myself, was the way that they skillfully managed to balance the heavy stuff with the lighter stuff. And here's what I mean by that. It would have been very, very easy to either make this film deathly serious and gruesome like The Purge, and it would have also been very, very easy to just make this a silly, stupid, clowny goofball comedy like Scary Movie 3 or something like that. But somehow, the writers, who I've never heard of before, managed to squish those two sensibilities together and walk that line throughout the entire course of the movie, where Grace and her new husband, Alex, are playing it very seriously. Like, they have a very touching through line over the course of this movie. Grace really loves Alex and she's terrified for her life. Alex, you can tell he's this lonely man where he's not all there because he grew up in this batshit crazy family, but he's looking at Grace like his ticket out. Like, he loves her, but she's also his escape into the real world, away from the Ladomas family and their literal embarrassment of riches. So it's this great little bittersweet story about these two people who love each other for their own strange reasons. And then on the other hand, you have the Ladomas clan themselves trying to hunt down Grace, which is played lighter, more for laughs, because due to the fact that they are these coked out, alcoholic, out of touch billionaires who have no idea what the real world is like, it turns out they're not all that competent when it comes to hunting down another human being. They're more of a danger to themselves than they are to Grace. So Ready or Not is constantly straddling that line of drama and comedy. And I love when films do that. And it does it really well. Again, I was continuously surprised throughout the course of the movie, because I would have moments where I was genuinely frightened, and I would have moments where I would laugh a lot, and then I would have moments where I was like, oh man, that's a really beautiful character arc they just did with this one person. It blends the cocktail together kind of seamlessly, nothing feels jarring, into this wonderful milkshake, this wonderful smoothie of just blood and gore and hurt feelings and social commentary. And it's capped off, the cherry on top of the milkshake is Grace herself, who is a fantastic badass action hero, and she earns that title. She doesn't start off as, she just starts off as a normal girl running around in her bride dress that she's very proud of, and then all of a sudden, you know, she has to get shit done, and she does. This whole recipe mixed together makes for a movie that was an absolutely delightful surprise. And you know what? I'm going to go right ahead and say it. Ready or Not is very good. Ready or Not is very good. You should see it at least once. If you liked Cabin in the Woods, you'll like Ready or Not. You'll walk away with that same sense of satisfaction and that same sense of quality. Great concept, great execution, great final product. I don't know what else you could ask for, except maybe an action figure of Grace, because damn, with that bandolier and the shotgun she picks up and her tattered bridal gown, this lady is a cool-looking action hero. Anyway, that is Ready or Not. That has been Thumb Together. My name is Andrew Fantasia. I will see you here next time. And until then, adios.